Hi there, and welcome to The Works. I'm Ben Che.
And I'm Ben Peltier. Coming up on the 27th of January, the Hong Kong music lover Chinese Orchestra is presenting a concert, New Vibes of Traditional Chinese Music Harmony. Members of the orchestra will be with us later to talk about how they are injecting new elements into their repertoire.
But we're beginning with an imagined world in which the legendary Chinese poet Qu Yuan, the man whose demise we commemorate every year during the Dragon Boat Festival, lives again 2,000 years after his death. How would a poet from the Kingdom of Chu in the Warring States period cope in a neon-lit cyberpunk future? That's the question posed by a current exhibition at Tai Kwun.
不如會唔會有第二個option嘅咧？如果一個同樣歷史、同樣想法嘅人，咁除咗投河自盡之外，會唔會有第二條路可以行嘅咧？
Kong Hong Chang, also known as Kongkee, is a Hong Kong comic artist and award-winning animation director. On show at Tai Kwun, Kongkee Warring States Cyberpunk showcases his works in a site-specific exhibition that includes three animations from his Dragon's Delusion series. In 2013, Kong created the comic series Mi Luo Virtual, which was published periodically in Mingpao Weekly magazine. In 2016, the story was developed further as the Dragon's Delusion series for City magazine. A year later, the series' first animated short, Dragon's Delusion Departure, was made. Two more, Assassination and Preface, followed. Last year, Kongkee published Dragon's Delusion, Cosmic Travel Agency, a full collection of the series.
畫嘅時候唔係好大嘅，其實卅幾歲嘅啫。咁嗰陣時咧就開始有種傷春悲秋嘅感覺啦嚇，即係而家睇翻就覺得好好笑嘅。咁但係我估個人都有咁上下嘅經歷，就係無論你其實你有冇離開過你個國家又好，只要你時間一過咗一個年份都好啦，你就會有一種以前嘅時間、以前認識嘅人、以前嘅地方，其實你翻唔到去。咁呢一種對同同 屋企呢個剝離呢個過程咧，其實我覺得就好想抒發出嚟。我成日覺得以前嘅人同我哋今日嘅人咧，喺個情感上、慾望上面嘅追求係唔係好大分別嘅？即係以前嘅春秋戰國時代，佢哋識得鑄青銅器之後，做咗好多好多武器。我哋今日有好多先進嘅科技，其實一樣會去到發展好多新嘅兵器出嚟。我哋其實用呢個角度睇嘅話，對於 點樣用科技去到滿足我哋無窮無盡嘅慾望呢一個點上面，其實係唔係咁大分別？咁所以喺啲作品入邊，我成日模糊化咗過去同現在，或者日與夜時間性嗰樣嘢係好模糊嘅喺作品入邊。What
you know？你投河自盡啊？
Dragon's Delusion tells the story of a humanoid robot called Zhou who inherits the memories of the Chinese poet Qu Yuan who lived in the Kingdom of Chu during the Warring States period. Zhou is intrigued by the idea of the human soul and of free will. The comic series, which includes intricate tales set in Hong Kong's urban landscape, is known for its vibrant and bold colors. In one area of the exhibition, there's a recreation of Kong's studio in which visitors can see much of his preparatory work.
呢邊就係屈原同楚王啦，咁然後一路行咧會夾雜一啲製作上面嘅手稿或者背景嘅圖啦，咁然後有一啲漫畫嘅章節，然後去到嗰邊咧就有阿祖同埋家父連嘅手稿嘅。離修幻閣入邊嗰啲顏色或者我好多作品入邊嘅顏色啦，都係一啲好原始啊，好跳動嘅顏色嚟嘅。我好中意啲傳統嗰啲木板畫一啲廟宇嗰啲顏色啊。咁我覺得呢一種感覺咧，佢好有力量。 而呢啲顏色又好少用喺啲科幻作品入邊嘅，通常啲科幻作品你諗起咧都係霓虹光啊，咁我就覺得呢兩種對事物嘅睇法混埋一齊嘅時候，有一個火花係好吸引，於是乎就放咗落我啲作品度。 呢幾年我做好多interactive或者有一啲光影嘅作品之後，我就發現其實呢一個係一個過程。其實呢一個係俾咁多刺激隻眼睛，其實係想你更加透過呢啲刺激感受到自己嘅存在。 我有個諗法嘅，講出嚟好笑嘅，就係咧青銅器其實咧係最遠古嘅重金屬音樂，因為佢係真係重金屬。咁所以我就覺得，其實可能以前嘅人佢都有夜夜笙歌嘅時間㗎。因為我成日記得一句説話咧，老子《道德經》講嘅就係五色令人目盲，五音令人耳聾。佢呢句説話嘅意思係想話，最後就係講你要揾到自己內在嘅自己先至係最重要嘅，唔好俾啲聲色犬馬攞咗你個心咁樣。
An exhibition with the same title was presented in 2022 at the Asian Art Museum in San Francisco. There was another a year later at the Wrightwood 659 Museum in Chicago. The Tai Kwun exhibition features two newly commissioned works, including this large-scale LED installation.
翻到嚟大館，亦都係一個好有歷史嘅建築啦，同埋香港本身嗰個歷史又有中西文化嘅。 交流啊、衝擊啊、各樣各樣，咁所以覺得今次呢個即係Homecoming呢件事，其實我覺得唔純粹係話翻到嚟我哋創作嘅地方，而係都有一種重新出發去揾即係home呢個意思係乜嘢嘢嘅一個想法喺入邊。而家又見到三個分開嘅monitor， 好似有三個唔同嘅角色講緊唔同嘅故仔。 呢個地方呢個 duplex studio 嘅時候咧，佢俾你個感覺好似入咗一座教堂咁樣，咁所以我就好想將呢個地方變成一個觀眾嚟到可以休息、可以沉思嘅地方。即對我本身其實就唔係有信仰嘅，但係其實我覺得去戲院睇戲對我嚟講就好似其他人去。 教堂一樣，即係望住發光嘅嘢喺度沉思啊、諗嘢啊咁。咁我覺得喺而家呢個時代或者呢個時刻，好多人都需要呢一種靜落嚟嘅空間。佢就叫做時間流動就係水，時間停頓就係山。咁因為我好鍾意畫一個手勢，就係隻手好似座山咁樣樣嘅。我成日覺得其實山同海都係一樣，都係流動。 只不過係我哋個生命太短暫，所以我哋只係見到一瞬間嘅山，你以為佢停咗喺度，其實佢同海一樣都係不停咁樣流動。咁呢個其實我哋都有歌詞講啊，變幻原是永恆啊嘛。咁所以我都希望喺藉住呢個展覽講人同科技同埋歷史嘅關係嘅時候，都帶出呢一個時間觀同大家分享。
In a room next to Old Bailey Street, this work is inspired by the Greek philosopher Heraclitus's observation, you can never step into the same river twice. It echoes themes from the exhibition, the concepts of time, memory, and identity.
藝術家創作呢件作品嘅時候咧，就係2020年 COVID 爆發嘅時間。其實佢都有一種被隔離喺屋企呢一種同好多人、同整個世界有一種好近，但係感覺非常之遙遠嘅距離。所以咧，我哋覺得將呢件作品擺喺呢個空間咧，就好承接到當時佢創作嘅情緒。 江記嘅作品《離騷幻覺》啦，其實佢有好多 punchline， 就好似佢講一個外國詩人屈原嘅故事啦。佢提出 what if，
Whispers of the Soul at Villepin Gallery is the first Hong Kong exhibition to focus on the work of Lawrence Carroll. The artist died in 2019. The exhibition, set up with the support of his wife, Lucy Jones Carroll, is a tribute to his unique practice of painting. Lawrence Carroll was born in Australia and raised in the United States, but spent most of his working life in Italy. His works are relatively monochromatic and often have three-dimensional objects or materials attached to their surface. He has said that his aim was to explore the painting as a body and not just as a flat surface, and to examine the relationship between painting and sculpture. Carroll's paintings are accompanied by works by photographer Francois Halat and by painters Giorgio Di Curico, Giorgio Morandi, and Cy Twombly, which help to evoke a sense of the Mediterranean.
Welcome back. Since its founding in 1979, the Hong Kong Music Lover Chinese Orchestra has given regular performances in Hong Kong and overseas. As its name reveals, Chinese music is at the core of its repertoire. But the orchestra doesn't just focus on traditional music. It also aims for innovation, as it's highlighting in its upcoming concert, New Vibes of Traditional Chinese Music, Harmony. Some of the orchestra's members are with us to tell us more.
Well, joining me here on the set is Jason, Zandra, and Brian. We're here to talk about the Hong Kong Music Lover Chinese Orchestra upcoming pair of concerts, really, in Yuen Long, on the 27th and the 1st, I understand. So the title of the overall program, New Vibes of Traditional Chinese Music, Harmony, is made up of some really interesting compositions. Perhaps you can take me through the program and what you have planned for these two concerts in Yuen Long.
We have four new Hong Kong premieres pieces in this concert, and with two concertos with Yan Qing and Pipa. Yeah, and our concept in this concert is based on the concerto melody. Yeah, it's Chinese name of melody is the same pronunciation of harmony in Chinese. Yeah, so we are going to produce more different pieces that Hong Kong people are seldom to hear that, or yeah, never heard it. And then we just put it on the stage and hope to give our audience a special experience.
Now, Brian, I do understand that your composition, in fact, is one of these Hong Kong premieres. That's the one that you'll be soloing on the Yang Qin. That's a Hong Kong premiere. So that must be rather exciting for you as an opportunity to bring music to a Hong Kong audience for the first time that's never been played here in Hong Kong before.
Of course, yes. The piece of my concerto, the Yang Qin concerto melody, is composed by Zhang Zhao. And in this piece, we will use different folk songs from different regions in the mainland China, such as Henan, Taiwan, and Mongolia. Yeah, and in this piece, I will use different tools instead of the traditional hammer of our Yang Qin. Yeah, we will also use spoon and chopsticks to play in this piece, to produce the different sound effects for that.
I'll turn to you now, Zandra. This pipa you have is magnificent looking. And also, the piece that you're playing is Hua Mulan, a traditional old story of the daughter stepping in place of her ill father and sort of going into the army, right?
Yeah.
How does that play out in terms of the pipa concerto that you're going to play?
First, this pipa concerto is composed by Mr. Qu Yuan in 1979, and the story everyone is familiar with. And throughout the whole pieces, there is three main sections. All the sessions is talking about the story, and the pipa soloist in the piece is just like being Mulan herself and talking the story, narrating it. So I think that is the most interesting point, like you are being in the story.
Jason, if I could turn to you and ask a little bit more generally about the ensemble.
Yes.
Maybe describe to us what this orchestra is, who is playing in there, and then some of the projects, some of the interesting projects that either you've already done or that you look forward to doing.
Actually, we have many different players come from the winners of the Hong Kong Music Festival. Actually, many of the professional player. And for 45 years, we did many of the project. We find many different kind of music, but we try to use our Chinese instrument to make a new face to the audience. We have a joint concert in the future with our sister organization, Kit Hong Chinese Orchestra, and to celebrate our friendship of 40 years. Yeah.
Magnificent. So here in the studio, we can't do a whole Pipa concerto, of course, but yet that's the piece you're playing on the program. What can you play for us here in the studio?
Yeah, sure. We will have a medley of our Pipa concerto and the Yangqing concerto together. And this is the duet of Pipa and Yangqing together to play some the excerpt from the Pipa concerto and the Yangqing concerto. Also, I will use these two, the chopsticks and the spoon, to play in this piece.
That's magnificent. Thank you all three so much for coming in, and I can't wait to hear that.
Thank you.
Thank you.